Hi, my name is Krish Advani, and today I'm going to talk a little bit about DNS. Now, DNS, which sometimes stands for Domain Name Server or Domain Name Service, both basically the same concept, eventually are used to translate or convert your domain names into IP addresses. What that means that eventually each and every service, as we all know, such as Facebook, Yahoo, Google, all of these services have got a domain name, which are facebook.com, google.com, yahoo.com, whatever. Each and every have a domain name assigned to it. But eventually, networking works on IP addresses, which are very easy to understand and learn, but they're difficult to remember. Eventually, you cannot remember IP addresses of each and every service that you use these days. So there was a concept introduced called as domain names. So each and every server has a domain name assigned to it, which is a static thing, doesn't change, and it goes through some steps in order to find its respective IP. So the steps is what, one of the steps is actually a DNS. So let me explain this a little bit better. Whenever you type in the URL in your web browser, let's take an example of facebook.com, it will go through something called as your ISP, which is your internet service provider. These are the people who provide you internet access. Then it goes to a DNS, which is the thing we are talking about right now. It will go in there and will go into a lookup table and will go and find out what is the IP of facebook.com. It has a table and will go through the entire table until it finds a respective IP. And if it does find it, it will go to the service, which is facebook.com's IP address, will find to the server and give you back the response on your web browser. But if your DNS doesn't find the IP address, what it does is eventually goes to even a bigger DNS server. And if that doesn't find it, it goes to one of the bigger ones. It's kind of a big fish concept. Small fish gets a bigger, then the medium-sized fish, then a bigger fish, and keeps on going until it finds the proper IP address. All right? This is the structure it follows. So then once you get your IP address, you'll get your response as well. So this is how DNS works. It might seem like a long process, but it eventually takes few milliseconds or sometimes a little bit of seconds. That's it. And you will get your website and your web browser that fast. What happens is that the DNS server, which does not have that page or IP address cached in it, will cache it once for a certain period of time and will leave it there so other users can access it rather than going to another DNS server and taking more time. So it's just making the process a lot faster. There are various kinds of DNS. There's a forward lookup and there's a reverse lookup. Forward lookup means you put in your domain name and you get the IP address, and a reverse lookup is all on the alternate side. Basically, you put in the IP address to get your domain name. Okay, both are different concepts. And then last thing I would like to talk about is the operating system IP address caching. So what happens is that your operating system, when you try to access a certain page again and again, your operating system eventually caches its IP address within the operating system itself. So rather than going to the DNS server, you will go directly to the server of the service you are trying to access. So it makes the process even a lot faster. But again, you cannot cache all the pages that you try to access because it requires tons of memory in this case. So that's why there's a need of DNS server. That's basically the concept of DNS. This has been Chandra Chaos. I hope you like this video. Rate, comment, subscribe. Thank you very much.